fragilistic, expialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Because I was afraid to speak, well, I was just a lad. My father gave me nails a tweak and told me I was bad. But then one day I learned a word to say, we ain't the nose.
The biggest word you ever heard, and this is how it goes. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Underlay.
He travelled all around the world and everywhere he went, he'd use his word and all would say, there goes a clever gent.
When Dukes and Martha Rogers pass a time of day with me, I say me special word and look me off, me off to two.
Woo!
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
But that's going a bit too far, don't you think?
Jupiter.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon this word and then you've got a lot to say. But better use it carefully or it could change your life.
For example?
Yes?
One night I said it to me girl, and now me girl's me wife. Oh, and a lovely thing she is too.
She's
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
It's not easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves. When I think it could be nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not easy being green. It seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over because you're not standing out like flashy sparkles in the water or stars in the sky. But green's the color of spring, and green can be cool and friendly like. And green can be big like a mountain, or important like a river, or tall like a tree. When green is all there is to be, it could make you wonder why. But why wonder? Why wonder? I'm green and it'll do fine. It's beautiful. And I think it's what I wanna be.
On a tree by the river, a little tomtit sang. This is your part, Sam.
Willow, tit willow, tit willow.
And I said to him, Dickie Bird. See, that's you, Sam. You play the part of the Dickie Bird. Why do you sit singing?
Dickie Bird. Willow, tit willow. Tid willow.
Is it weakness of intellect, Birdie, I cried? Not meaning you.
Yes.
Or a rather tough worm in your little inside? With a shake of his poor little head, he replied,
Willow, tit willow, tit willow.
Mm-hmm. Now I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name isn't
Willow, tit willow, tit willow.
That 'twas blighted affection that made him exclaim.
You want to do this? Willow, tit willow, tit willow.
And if you remain callous and obdurate, I...
What's obdurate?
I don't know, sir. Shall perish as he did, and you will know why. Though I probably shall not exclaim as I die. This is the last one, Sam.
Willow, tit willow, tit willow.
Okay, time once again for that furry, fuzzy, funny man, fabulous, freewheeling, fast and frantic, Fozzie Bear!
Hey, 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 hey! Oh, wait, 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 Froggy, not what? So fast. Tonight, I am going to use your assistance.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, sir. You and I are going to tell the world's funniest joke. This is all spontaneous, unrehearsed, right, Froggy?
It's unrehearsed, yes.
Okay, okay. Now, Frog of my heart,
yes.
You will just wait until I say the word here. When you hear me say the word here, you will rush up to me and say, good grief, the comedian's a bear.
Good grief, the comedian's a bear.
Check.
When you say the word here.
Right.
Gotcha.
Okay, now then. Hiya, hiya, hiya. You're a wonderful looking audience. It's a pleasure to be here.
Good grief, the comedian's a bear.
Not yet.
But you just said here.
That was the wrong here.
Which is the right here?
The other here.
Sure.
Go, go, go. Okay. Hey, hey, folks. This is a story you're gonna love to hear.
Good grief, the comedian's a bear.
Will you stop that?
But you said here.
Not that here.
Well, which here?
Another here.
How am I gonna know?
You know when you hear.
Good grief, the comedian's a bear.
All right, all right. Listen,
yes.
You will know when I point to you.
I'm not gonna work with another bear.
All right, don't grumble.
I'm never gonna work with another bear.
Say, a funny thing happened to me on the way to the theater. At the stage door, I passed a bunch of Muppet fans, and suddenly I hear...
Good grief, the comedian's a bear.
No, he's a nut. He's a wearing a necktie. Ah!